Okay, gang, Velobuild. Some people ask me on my opinion on the Velobuild bikes. They look a lot like Specialized Tarmac SL6. I've never ridden one of these bikes. I did contact Chris, who runs this website, and I said, ask him a few questions about the bikes. So if you would like to get me to get one of these frames, which frame would you like me to get? And Give this video a thumbs up if you want to see me get one of these bikes. Two things I want from you, if I could, is one, thumbs up if you want me to get one, and second, leave a comment which model you'd like me to get. If you don't want me to get one, give the video a thumbs down. The bike that I like the look of the most is this bad boy here. This is called the VBR 86. It retails for $379 US. And why I like it is because it has direct mount brakes, and apparently it can fit 30mm tyres in this. So this is like a poor man's SL6. My only issue with this bike is it comes with a seat post that is proprietary, meaning if you do happen to crack it in a crash, then you have to contact Velobuild and get another one. It's not like a 27.2 seat post. So it does have BB386, which is a great design. So there you go. So this bike gives my thumbs up. It doesn't have a brazed on derailleur mount, but if you're running 4630, then you'll be fine for gearing, in my opinion. So this looks like a beater bike, a nice bike. So this is my pick out of a lot if I had a choice. So yeah, direct mount brakes. If you've had a Velobuild bike, let me know what your experience was. What's been your experience? The weight, it's not super light. It's 1,000 grams, roughly. Zero setback pros or 20mm setback. I'll probably get zero setback. That's just my personal preference. But if you've had one of these bikes, let me know down below what was your opinion of it. It's pretty aggressive. It's almost like a Cannondale Super 6 geometry. So there you go. That's the Velobuild first impressions. A Velobuild shit or legit? You let me know down below if you would like me to get one of these bikes. Give it a thumbs up. Which model would you like me to get? Would you like me to get the VBR 86? We will talk soon. Have you had any experience with Velobuild bikes? And what's the deal? It's amazing how cheap they can be made for, isn't it? It's incredible. No bike in the industry, I'd say, would cost more than a few other bikes to make. Even the $8,000 frame ones coming out of Asia. Interesting stuff. Are these bikes safe? Are these bikes a liability? I mean, I've seen my S-Works bike, the fork, it's about to fail. Lucky I picked it up. The bearing in the headset failed. Caused what we call the wing of death, where it etches out the carbon. So it doesn't, don't think because you've got a big name bike that has got to be safe all the time. You always got to maintain your bike by checking it yourself, learning what to look for, things like that, and keep safe out there. And if you have any issues, go to your local bike shop, ask them for their opinion. But even then, a lot of bike shops don't have much experience dealing with the carbon. And they'll say, yeah, it's all right, looks all right. But it might be not. So, yeah. Carbon's a great material. It can be fixed. It can't be recycled, but it can be fixed. But also, you want to inspect it regularly. And if you're a heavyweight rider, over 90 kilos, over 85, I don't really recommend carbon for you. That's my comments, criticisms. You share yours down below and we'll see you on the road. There's only 19 of these on the road. 19. So it's a pretty exclusive bike.